What do you want to do tonight?
The same thing we do every night, Pinky. Try to take over the world.
Hey, what is up, cuties? It is your fave, Patty Next Door, and I am back after a really long while. Apologies. Okay, like 2 weeks, but you know, like, school is hectic, life is hectic. I just needed a break. So I'm gonna tell you 5 things I wish I knew before I went into med school. It's like, yeah, I wish someone could have said something. Like, imposter syndrome. This is a very big one, at least for me. So it's like you constantly feel like you don't know enough or you're not prepared for what you're expected to be doing. So these are even like the smallest things, like answering a question that the doctor is asking you. It's like you know, but you're just not sure that you're right. So I feel like the best way around that is to fake it until you make it, and obviously to always be prepared, you know, to always be 110%. But that's hard to do when there's so much to learn, you know. So I feel like imposter syndrome is, it's like it's a fair struggle to go through, but it can be overcome by actually knowing your shit, you know, and being on top of your work, like, consistently. But yeah, that's not always the easiest thing to do, because sometimes your life gets in the way of being the best student you can be, and that can really take a toll on confidence and you just feeling like you know your stuff. The cost of med school, I'm pretty sure, like, everything, especially in South Africa, costs a lot. To study further than high school costs a lot of money, but med school in particular is just guys, I feel like they should be paying us to be training as medical doctors, because it's never less than 60k a year, and that's a lot of money to pay, especially when, like, it's an expensive thing to go into. Because, okay, this brings me to the third point, which is that I wish someone told me that I needed to have a car this whole time. Oh, because the campus is not at the main campus. So, and for me especially, I'm a day student, so I don't live at a student res or whatever. So it was having to go to campus and come back all without a car, and having to rely on someone to pick me up, or having to take an Uber because I'm late, or having to take the bus and having to wait 3 hours after my test so I can catch the bus home and stuff like that. It's just the most inconvenient thing, and it's so frustrating. So I wish someone told me I should have gotten my license in matric if I wanted to do medicine, and I should have, if possible, have saved up for a car, have talk to my parents about the necessity of having a car, because it's not a privilege, it's a necessity. You need a car. So you need to be able to plan and have self-control and limitations with how much you're going to do this weekend because of what you need to do on Monday, you know. So you need to make, so the only way to make time for a life outside of being a med student is to manage your time well. And that brings me to the fifth point, and probably the most important, because all these other things, sure, you can go through them, you can learn through them, you can grow through them, but do not throw away your notes. I wish someone told me, do not throw away your notes from first year. Don't throw your notes away. Like, the work does not change. You're not all of a sudden never gonna do this or never gonna do that. Okay, maybe you can throw away your notes from first semester or first year, because that's like physics and chemistry. I mean, you're not gonna need to know the chemical formula for tetrahydroxide, oxymoron, sulfide, you know? So that you can throw away. But as soon as you start the syllabus on the medical campus, don't throw away any notes you make. Like, compartmentalize and organize your notes and folders and files and folders on your laptop, you know, like, write your from block one, write block one, block two, block three, block four, everything. You will always need to reference back your notes. Being a medical student is not a personality trait, and you don't have to fit into a certain type of lifestyle. You don't need to fit into a certain type of lifestyle. If your life is balanced, your life is balanced. What's my point is that being a medical student is not a personality trait. So don't put those type of stereotypes on every med student you meet, and don't expect to like have to act a certain way when you get to class, or like suddenly change how you dress because everyone else dresses a certain way, or you know, or change your hairstyle. You know, obviously you need to like look presentable and neat because you'll be dealing with a lot of different people. I wish someone told me to be social and to make, not even make friends, because you don't need that many friends, but you need to be acquainted with a lot of different people. Don't stay in your little circle. Branch out and meet new people and form groups of people you don't know, because that is what it will be expected of you, to be able to communicate and to be like a boss. Like don't depend on your friends. Don't not join a course because your friends aren't doing it. You get me? Be an individual who is able to work in a team. Period. And that is it. Those are things I wish I knew before med school, before getting in, doing, applying, being. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you learned something. I hope you can relate. And don't forget to comment, a like, and share. Lots of love. I'll see you in my next video. I have so much content lined up, so don't die on me, guys. Don't be ghost subscribers, please.